Hello, my name is Peter Iliev. I'm the artistic director of Iliev Dance Art Foundation, and I teach character dance as well. Yes. This is our fifth edition of our program. Very successful. The way we measure success is this year, because we have 150 kids. I think that the program proves that Bulgarian dancers need something like this, and it's not enough. Unfortunately, our program is only 1 week, but it's very, very challenging, just not for the dancers, but also for the teachers. Every idea can be great, but if you don't have the financial support, it can die very easy. Last year, we applied for a grant from America, Foundation America for Bulgaria, and I think they believe they actually read our proposal and they decided to support us. And that was a great, great opportunity for us to move and expand our program. I really want to thank them for their financial support, because this year, again, they are supporting us, and that's tremendous. That means that they believe and they know the value of the program. The challenge of this program, I think, that we're facing this year is that we have so many students that want to participate. I think that's one challenge. And we cannot, if you see it right now in the studio, we have 58 kids who are taking ballet class in a very small studio.
Nicholas Ade. I'm currently principal of the Pacific Northwest Ballet School's East Side School in Bellevue, Washington, in the United States. I started dancing at a fairly young age, and I've attended North Carolina School of the Arts and was also trained at San Francisco Ballet before dancing with Pacific Northwest Ballet under Francia Russell and Kent Stoll and Peter Bull. And I've been teaching for quite a few years while I was dancing, and was also named principal after retiring in 2006. We learn different styles and things and different ways of moving in ballet. We accept and are part of a global dance opportunity to be able to learn more about other people's cultures and stylistic things that they do. And the students here have been so accepting of it. Even on our first class, they were really listening and really understanding what I was asking of them. And it seems like it's going to be a fantastic week.
Yesterday, when we started, the first thing that I walked into was something that was amazing, something that I've seen on Broadway. When they announce big production, there is casting for dancers, professionals dancers, and then you see line around the theaters of dancers who want to be seen and be part of the great idea of the choreographers and producers who have. That's how I felt yesterday. The whole hallway and stairways downstairs were full of dancers, ready to go, eager to learn, but also not knowing what to expect.
Turn your hand forward. Right hand on.
Hi, my name's Marcus Galante. I'm from New York City. I started in the ballet professionally. For many years I danced all over the world, and then I decided to go into Broadway. So I started studying jazz, and I got auditioned for a lot of shows, and I did a lot of shows on Broadway and national tours, which was a lot of fun. I've done television, I've done movies, and now I've retired from that and I teach all over the world. I'm in Bulgaria for my third time. It's a great experience here with the Iliev Dance Foundation, and I'm really enjoying it, so I hope I will be back.
Foundation is giving scholarships every year, This year we have five. We have one for New York, two for Chicago, one for Los Angeles, and one for Seattle, PNB. We will have five recipients of scholarships, and they will be in United States for 6 intensive weeks. Similar model to what we do, except for 6 weeks.
My name is Christian Von Howard. I am an American artist from New York City. I am the artistic director of the Von Howard Project, and I teach at the Alvin Ailey School. In my workshop class here, yes, I'm kind of combining. I'm actually doing more with classical modern ideas, like Horton and Graham, and then kind of combining the African aesthetic inside of it, working with rhythms so the dancers here can understand different rhythms and different ways to go in and out of the floor. The students that I'm teaching now, I just want them to take everything that I'm giving them, the ideas of rhythm and the ideas of just having fun and enjoying dance, to keep taking that with them in every experience that they have.
Quality of teaching, and that's very important. Our program is based on teaching, based on teachers who care about what they do. They care about the kids, about giving them and giving them and wanting more, pushing them always, pushing them to their limit. It's not like, I can do tandu. Good, very good. Yeah, no. It's pushing, always improving, moving more, and I think that's very important.
Hello, my name is Andrea Burr. I'm a hip-hop dancer located in Los Angeles, California.
Yeah. If you're like,
they're just so happy to get some hip-hop training, I think, because there's not a lot of studios that train in hip-hop out here. Lots of the kids come up to me and they tell me how they wish they could train in all the styles, and they're sad that the classes overlap because they want to take everything. And I love how enthusiastic they are about taking everything.
Excuse me, miss. What's your name? I don't want to tell you the same old thing. Drop it low, make it pop. I can do this all night, shorty. I don't want to stop. I need to go, girl. I need to go, girl.
So far, our foundation is giving about 24 scholarships, and I think for 5 years this is unbelievable. It's unheard of. I don't know any other program in Bulgaria that does this, because I strongly believe in that's what they need. They need to dance, they need to move, they need to be in very close contact with different choreographers, because dance world today is moving fast. They cannot stay in one style and say, oh, I'm a great dancer. Uh-uh. Cross, just walk the stage and show me what you got. So far we've had, 300 and something participants in our program. We are trying to expand to different countries. We were successful 2 years ago in Montenegro, and here we are again in Sofia, and I hope that we can do it longer. I hope dancers always ask, 1 week is not enough, we need 2, we need 3, and we're going to give them that very soon.